Here we are again together on YouTube, and the topic of today's video is going to be 5G. Before I get straight into it, I just have a quick ask. Now, I work in IT sales, and it is my job to present things simple and easy and very understandable. So, if you find something you like, if you find something you don't like that you think I can improve, please comment that below. Right, thank you. Now let's get straight back into the presentation. Now the agenda today is going to be that we take a quick look at 4G versus 5G. What has changed? What implications does it have? And then we look at some areas where 5G is going to have an effect. Now, 4G first appeared on US phones back in 2010. And then it took a couple of years before actual 4G applications started to come out. So Snapchat came in 2012, and then Uber became widely popular in 2013. We also saw video calls being popularized. Now, 5G is a lot different than 4G in many ways. 4G had big towers and long wavelengths, but 5G, it's more diverse. You have the low band, you have the mid band, and you have the high band. And the US focuses more on low and high band, while Europe focuses more on mid band. Now, what this means in practice is that 4G can travel longer ranges, and you don't need to put up a lot of infrastructure. By 5G, you need to put up these little boxes that you can see on the left of the screen. And you have to put them up quite frequently because the short wavelengths of 5G is interfered by water. So in order for you to not lose connection when it starts raining, you have to put up a lot of these boxes. And also remember this, even though we're seeing 5G being rolled out now, it's going to take 1 or 2 years before we start seeing actual 5G applications being widely used. Now, the G in 5G simply means generation. So this is the fifth generation of wireless technology. And it brings up a lot of new possibilities, such as bigger channels, lower latency. Basically, everything is going to become faster. Now, imagine wireless technology, your Wi-Fi being just as fast as Ethernet. It's around those areas we're talking. Now, take a moment to think about, what does this mean for you? What type of applications do you think that you're going to see in your line of work or as a consumer? Now, one of the areas where 5G is being talked about a lot is IoT. Now, IoT is short for Internet of Things. And why it is being talked about in IoT is due to the high speeds 5G will bring. Now, this is going to allow fast communications. For example, say you want to teach a car a new maneuver, you can update that via ultra-fast 5G. So maybe teach it to do a new type of parking maneuver, or do a software update, or something like that. We can even theorize outside billboards showing ads being able to monitor impressions and recognizing facial expressions to see how people react to ads. There are a lot of potentials besides just the smart home devices and all those other things commonly thought about when speaking about IoT. So this is going to be a big trend coming forward. Let's also take a quick look at edge computing with regards to 5G. Now, I wanted to bring up a consumer perspective here, because new virtual reality and gaming applications will be able to leverage this new technology. And we're going to see infrastructure and, service providers that give this structure is going to focus a lot on this, and the edge capabilities that are going to be brought forward as part of this new 5G infrastructure being built today. So, this has been 5G, simply explained. Thank you very much for listening.